Join Douglas McMillan every Sunday afternoon at 2 for an hour of music and song from the Celtic nations and beyond. In traditional and modern styles and in languages both native and adopted, hear the Celtic world brought right to your home through the magic of radio. That's Celtic World, Sundays at 2 on Otago Access Radio, 105.4 FM and 1575 AM, and online at www.oar.org.nz.
Hello and welcome to Celtic World. I'm your host, Douglas McMillan. The 25th of January 2018 marks the 259th anniversary of the birth of Scottish poet, lyricist and erstwhile farmer Robert Burns. This show, on the eve of his birthday, is an opportunity to celebrate his contribution to literature and song and to explore some interpretations of his work by the artists who appear hereafter. First up, to kick the show off, is a track by Janet Russell and Christine Kidd with their version of the 1792 poem Duncan Grey. Some say the guitar riff in this version bears a similarity to Joni Mitchell's Big Yellow Taxi. Personally, I hear a vague resemblance to Neil Diamond's Cheery Cheery. As always, the truth lies somewhere in between the two. It sounds like neither.
Duncan Grey, come here to woo. Ah, ah, thoo. A note on blithe all night when we were foo. Ah, ah, thoo. A note Maggie Custer, he flew high. Looked asclent in Nunca sky. Garth here, Duncan, stand by. Ah, ah, thoo. A note Duncan fleeced and Duncan prayed. Ah, ah, thoo, a note, Meg was deep as Ailsa Craig. Ah, ah, thoo, a note, Duncan sighed be thootin. Gratazine be bleared and blin. Sparkle out in our alin. Ah, ah, thoo, a note. Time and chance are but a tide. Ah, ah, thoo, a note, slighted love is sair to bide. Ah, ah, thoo, a note, shall I like a fool, quoth he, for a haughty his edie, she can gang to France for me. Ah, ah, thoo, a note. How it comes, let doctors tell. Ah, ah, thoo, a note, make you see. He grew hail. Ah, ah, thou a note. Something in her bosom rings for the leaf a sigh she brings. Hello, harem they spark sick things. Ah, ah, thou a note. Duncan was a lad of grace. Ah, ah, thou a note. Maggie's was a piteous case. Ah, ah, thou a note. Duncan couldna be her dee. Rise in pity, smoor his wrath. Knew their cruise and candy bay. Ah, ah, thou a note.
Next up is the Sangsters with their version of the 1789 song Willie Brewed a Peck of Malt, a lusty song about three lusty lads in an all-night drinking session. Some things never change much, do they?
Just a drappy and moody. The cock may craw, the day may daw, and I will taste the barley breed. Here are we met, three merry boys, I trow are we. And money a net, we merry be, and money may we. We are na fool, we're never fool, but just a drappy and moody. The cock may crow, the day may I will taste the barley green. It is the moon, I ken her home, that's blinking in the lift city. She shines so pretty, why was he? And by my sooth, she'll wait till me. We are na fool, or never fool, but just a drappy and moody. The cock may crow, the day may dawn, and I will taste the barley green. War first shall rise, day gang a war, a cockle coward loon is he. War first beside his chair shall fall, he is the king among us. We are na fool, or never fool, but just a drappy and moody. The cock may crow, the day may dawn, and I will taste the barley green. We are na fool, or never fool, but just a drappy and moody. The cock may crow, the day may dawn, and I will taste the barley breed.
There appears to be no consensus on whether the following is a veiled Jacobite song or simply a poem from the point of view of the daughter of the Laird of Knockhaspe, with whom one Harry Lonsdale had an illicit relationship. It is the 1792 poem Highland Harry Back Again, here performed by Sam Spears.
Back again, oh, for him back again. I went ye on a Caspi's land for Highland Harry back again. My Harry was a gallant gay, foo stately straight he on the plain, but knew he Spanish for a while. Never see him back again. Oh, brought him back again. Oh, brought him back again. I went ye on a Caspi's land for Highland Harry back again. When all the lady to the bed, I wandered down up the glen. Set me down and greet my fowl, and I wish him back again. Oh, for him back again. Oh, for him back again. I went ye on a Caspi's land for Highland Harry back again.
Back again. Oh, brought him back send Harry back again. Back again. Back again.
Leezy Lindsay is a 1795 poem Burns adapted from an older traditional poem, of which only a fragment remains. Two versions of Burns' poem exist, and the following song draws from the second version, where Leezy responds to the male voice of the first verse. Performing Leezy Lindsay is the group Kingdom.
Though ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay, will ye gang to the Highlands with me? Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay, my bride and my darling to be? Ye gang to the Highlands with you, sir. I dinna ken how that may be, for I ken nor the land that ye live in, nor ken I the lad I'm gone with. Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay? Will ye gang to the Highlands with me? My bride and my darling to be. Leezy lassie, tis little that ye ken, if it be that ye downa ken me. For my name is Lord Ronald MacDonald, a chieftain o' high degree. Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay? Will ye gang to the Highlands with me? Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay? My bride and my darling. Kilted her coat so green satin, she has kilted them up to the knee, and she's off with Lord Ronald MacDonald, his bride and whose darling to be. Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay? Will ye gang to the Highlands with me? Will ye gang to the Highlands, Leezy Lindsay, his bride and his darling to be?
Another song and another band. This time it's the Hudson Swan Band, with a song called Collier Laddie, their version of the 1792 poem My Collier Laddie. Unlike Leezy Lindsay, the woman in this poem knows what she wants, eschewing fortune for the love of her collier laddie.
She says his mistress Jean.
Now for Ian Bruce with Raving Winds, his version of the 1788 song Raving Winds About Her Blowing, intended to be sung to the tune MacGregor of Warrow's Lament. Of this song, Byrne said, "I composed these verses on Miss Isabella MacLeod of Raza, alluding to her feelings on the death of her sister and the still more melancholy death of her sister's husband, the late Earl of Lunden, who shot himself out of sheer heartbreak at some mortifications he suffered owing to the deranged state of his finances."
Raving winds around her blowing, yellow leaves the woodland strowing, by a river hoarsely roaring, Isabella straight deploring. Farewell hours that late did measure, sunshine days, oh joy and pleasure. Hail the gloomy night of sorrow, cheerless night that knows no morrow. La da li a da da da. Da da li a dum da dum, da da li a da da dum, da li a da li a da da dum. O'er the past too fondly wandering, on the hopeless future pondering. Chilly grief my life blood freezes, fell despair my fancy seizes. Life the soul of every blessing, load to misery most distressing. Gladly how would I resign thee, and to dark oblivion join thee. Raven winds around her blowing, yellow leaves the woodland strowing, by a river hoarsely roaring, Isabella straight deploring. Da 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 da.
Here's Kev Thompson with his song Esterine, I Had a Pint of Wine, which is actually the 1790 poem The Golden Locks of Anna, of which Thompson's title is the first line. The poem has a sentiment similar to My Collier Laddie, but in this poem it is a male voice that declares his love to be of greatest worth. Thank you.
Yestreen I had a pint of wine, a place where bodies sauna. Yestreen lay on this breast of mine, the golden locks of Anna. The hungry dew in wilderness, rejoicing o'er his manna. Was Nathan Tay my honey bliss upon the lips of Anna? Ye monarchs, take the east and west from Indus to Savannah. Give me within my straining grasp the melting form of Anna. There I'll despise imperial charms, an empress or sultana. With dying raptures in her arms, I'll give and take with Anna. O, thy flaunting god of day, O, thy pale Diana, it star go hide thy twinkling ray when I'm to meet Diana. Come in thy raven plume each night, sun, moon, and stars withdrawn, and bring an angel pen to write my transports with. The cark and state me joy tell today sick things I mourn. The cark and state may go to hell, and I'll go take Diana. For she is the sunshine, O my ye, to live but hard I can. Had I on earth but wishes three, the first should be Diana.
You're listening to Celtic World on Otago Access Radio, 105.4 FM. Real people, real radio.
Robin sharing hairst, I share away him. Finta you could I get us stuck by him. I get up to Duns to warp away a bleeding. I'll test daddy's yet warm at me, but Robin sharing hairst, I share away him. Finta you could I get us stuck by him. Robin sharing hairst, I share away him. Finta you could I get us stuck by him. Was the robin bold, though I was a carter, played me second trick, me the elder's daughter. Robin sharing hairst, I share away him. Finta you could I get us stuck by him. Oh, 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 oh. feathered and wet. Alone and shaded and pierced, I shared a way and bent to you. Could I let us snack by? Sheer way and funter you could I better stack by him lagged out he duns to warp a warp a blighten a test at easy yet war met me but Robin share and hearst I share way and funter you could I better stack by him.
That was Robin Shearer and Hirst, Burns' 1789 adaptation of a traditional song about, quote, the imagined voice of the lower class woman impregnated and betrayed, unquote. This version is the censored version, with the words three goose feathers and a whittle, referencing Burns' lawyer friend Robin Ainslie, replacing the luder original twa trumps and a whistle, the meaning of which I shall leave to the listener's imagination. Performing Robin Shearer and Hirst was Christine Sparks. Logan Braes is a 1793 song intended to be sung to the tune of Logan Water. The song stands in stark contrast to the previous one. Here a faithful wife laments that her husband is away serving in the army, unable to fulfil his duties as husband, father and helpmeet as he had done so faithfully before his departure. Performing Logan Braes is the group Deaf Shepherd.
Oh, Logan, sweetly did thou glide the day I was my Wally's bride, and jeers and sighing the hours run. Like Logan to the summer sun, but noon flurry banks up. Drumly winter, dark and drear, while my dear lad, mun faces his face. For me and Logan Braes. Month of May has made our hills and valleys gay. The bards rejoice neath leafy boughs. The bees hum round the breathing flues. Blithe morning lifts his rosy eye, and evening's tears. Tears a joy, my soul delectless surveys, while Wally's for free Logan Braes. yen yon milk white hawthorn bush. Mang her nestlings sits the thrush, her faithful maid will share her torn. Or we songs her cares beguile, but I, my sweet nursling, seer, nae maid to help, nae maid to cheer, past widowed necks and joyless days. While Wally's for free Logan prays. As ye might money a fond head moan, say me it on your heed's return. How can your flinty hearts enjoy the widow's tear, the orphan's cry? But send me peace, bring happy days, and Wally came to Logan Place.
And now Ed Miller with McPherson's Farewell, a 1788 song to the tune of McPherson's Rant. This is Burns' version of a song supposedly written by the outlaw James McPherson just prior to his execution on 16th of November 1700. According to the story, McPherson composed the song and accompanying tune under the gallows that would end his life. He performed the song and asked of the assembled crowd who would play it at his wake. When no one replied, he smashed his fiddle and went to his death with the remark, "No one else shall play Jamie McPherson's fiddle." The remains of the fiddle are to be found at the Clan McPherson Museum.
Dark and strine, farewell, farewell to thee. McPherson's time will not be lying on yonder gallows tree. Say rantingly, say wantonly, and say dauntingly, gave he. He played a tune and he danced at the run below the gallows tree. Untie these bands, fray off my hands, and gie to me my sword.
And there's no a man in all Scotland but I'll brave him at a word. Say rantingly, say wantonly, and say dauntingly, gaed he. He played a tune and he danced a turn below the gallows tree. There's some come here to see me hang, and some to buy my fiddle. But before that I depart with her, I'll break her through the middle. Say rantingly, say wantonly, and say dauntingly, gaed he. He played a tune and he danced a turn below the gallows tree. Fiddling to bathe o' his hands, and he's broke it o'er a sneen. Seen there's nae other hand shall play on thee when I am deed in vain. Say rantingly, say wantonly, and say dauntingly, gaed he. He played a tune and he danced a turn below the gallows tree. The reprieve was coming o'er the brig of Banff to set Macpherson free. But they put the clock a quarter afore and they hanged him to the tree. Say rantingly, say wantonly, and say dauntingly, gaed he. He played a tune and he danced a turn below the gallows tree.
This next song is called Lament to Mary, Queen of Scots by Joanne Gilmartin. It's from Burns's 1791 Lament, the full title of which being Lament of Mary, Queen of Scots on the Approach of Spring. It's a very nice poem, this one. It's packed full of nature imagery. And here it is.
New nature hangs her mantle green on every blooming tree, and spreads her sheets of daisies white out o'er the grassy lea. New Phoebus cheers the crystal streams and glads the azure skies, but naught can glad the weary wight that fast endurance lies. New lavrocks wake the merry morn aloft on dewy wing. The merl wi' his noontide bower makes woodland echoes ring. The mavis, mild by many a note, sings drowsy day to rest. In love and freedom they rejoice, with care nor thrall oppressed. New blooms the lily by the bank, the primrose doon the brae, the hawthorns budding in the glen and milk white as the sleigh. The meanest hind in fair Scotland may rove their sweets amang, but I, the Queen of all Scotland, mun lie in prison strang.
Was the Queen of Bonnie France, where happy I be.
Song track from Michaelius, The Ranton Dog and the Deal Zawar with the Excise Man. The first is a 1786 song, the full title of which is The Ranton Dog, the Daddy Oat, intended for the tune Where'll Our Good Men Lie. The second is a 1792 poem. This is a great original interpretation from a very talented duo.
What my baby clothes will buy, what will tempt me when I cry, what will kiss me when I lie, the ranting dog, the daddy old. What will all he did the fort, what will buy the groaning mort, what will tell me how to court, the ranting dog, the daddy old. When I'm out the creepy chair, tell me what will set beside me there. Gie me rob, I'll seek nae mair, the ranting dog, the daddy oat. Wha will crack tae me my lane? Wha will clack me fidgin fame? Wha will kiss me out again, the ranting dog, the daddy oat. baby clutes will buy? Wha will tend me when I cry? Wha will kiss me where I lie? The ransom dog, the daddy won't. When I'm out the creepy chair, wha will sit beside me there? Gie me rob, I'll seek nae mair. The ransom dog, the daddy.
That's almost it for the 2018 Robert Burns Show here on Celtic World. Brought to you through Otago Access Radio 105.4 FM 1575 AM. Streaming live and podcast from oar.org.nz. The final track brings us full circle, in fact. It is another version of Duncan Gray. This one arranged by New Zealand's very own Don McGlashan. The track is called End Credits, and in brackets featuring Duncan Gray. It is the music that was played over the closing credits of the film adaptation of Janet Frame's autobiography, An Angel at My Table. I hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for listening.